Hello viewer, and welcome back to Artistry. In our last session, we discussed about wiring systems, and we have seen that in domestic purposes or domestic installation, we have two wiring systems, that is the service wiring and PVC conduit wiring system. We are going to see other wiring systems that are applicable in both commercial and industrial setup. The other wiring system that is commonly used in the industry and also commercial building is the use of steel conduits. Steel conduits offer better mechanical protection, and other than that, they are also impervious to chemical action, because the steel conduit that is used is a galvanized type, which means that it does not react that much with the atmosphere. This is very much applicable in industries where there is a lot of movement of material and human, and especially in floor shops, whereby you have a big room and there are machines that are installed. So you find that sometimes it is not possible to have all the wiring system done on the wall, because some of the machine might be at the center of the room, and you need to supply it. And in such a scenario, you find that the most applicable means of supplying that equipment or that machine would be the use of a steel conduit. A steel conduit looks like this. It looks like this. Just as we had seen in our last session, it is a cylindrical pipe. But now, the earlier one that we had seen was made of PVC, but now this one is made of steel material that is also galvanized. As you can see, it is galvanized, which means that it does not react that much with the atmosphere. And of course, it is quite strong. So when the cables are running through it, it means that they have a better protection against mechanical damage that would probably destroy them. So that's what we refer to as a steel conduit. And just as we have seen, the steel conduit also comes in sizes. We have one that is small, 16 millimeter. We have 20 millimeter. We have 25. And we have 32 millimeters. So that is the sizes that we have for conduit. We have the same for PVC conduit, but we are saying that steel conduit offers a better mechanical protection. Plus, other than that, you can also use the steel conduit as a CPC. You can still use the steel conduit as a CPC. CPC, you can use it as a CPC, but that one might, that one must conform to the IE regulation that all the conduit joints and termination must be of solid solid connection, which means that they offer electrical continuity, and they are not broken. They are not broken at any other part. But that would that must be observed, so that we are allowed to use the steel conduit as the CPC. And CPC we mean circuit protective conductor for earthing, and you had seen earlier. So that is one of the other addition that we have seen for now. The other one Number four, there is something that we refer to as trunking. Trunking, wiring system. And in trunking wiring system, instead of using a circular pipe for allowing conductors to, or for allowing wires to go through, we can use a rectangle one. And what happens in this wiring system is that you have something that is made of like a trunk, something like that, and then of course it has a covering. It has a covering on top, such that it is covered like so, and we have conductors or wires going through it, and of course. The good thing with this trunking is that because it can be made into different sizes, which means that it can be able to carry a higher amount of cables than in conduit. Plus, the trunking can either be PVC, can either be PVC or metallic. If it is metallic, it must be galvanized. If it is metallic, it must be galvanized. And if it is PVC, it has no problem. So that is the other wiring system that could be used. And this one is very attractive when it comes to commercial building and industries, because in such a setup, you'll find that you need so many cables to supply the equipment and other machinery that might be there. So in such a scenario, instead of running too many steel pipes or PVC conduit, you would use a trunking, because it makes the work even more neat and even more safer. So that's the other wiring system that we can see. The other wiring system that is also commonly used, number five, is the use of armored cable. And what happens with this armored cable is that the cable just is like this. The cable is like this, but instead of relying on the on this sheath alone, it relies on another metallic armoring plus a covering on top of it. And by that armoring, because the armoring is made of steel wires, it makes the wire to be very strong, and is not it's not possible to easily injure the conductors inside the conduit, inside the sheath, the inner sheath that we have, and we have it like so. So in summary, we say that these are the five common types of wiring systems that are normally used, both in the domestic and industrial setups, for protecting the cables. We have service wiring used mostly in domestic. We have PVC conduit wiring system. This one has is used both in domestic and commercial setups. We have steel conduit, which is normally used in industry and more so floor shops where you have machines that are running. We have trunking. Trunking, this one is also commonly used in both commercial and industrial setups, where you need to pass so many numbers of wires, and we also have armored cable, which is normally used for supplying power in underground systems. Underground, so that if you have one building and want to supply the other one, another building that is a distance apart, you can only use this wired armored cable system. And with that, we have seen all the wiring systems that are that are possible in both domestic, commercial, and industrial setups. We'll go for a short break, and when we come back, we are going to see in details how these wiring systems are physically done. Stay tuned.